Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Crusader Kings 2. It is I, the Golden Joeblivion, and allow me to introduce a new miniseries on the channel. It'll be probably the same as the last two miniseries we had, 10 episodes or so. This one is featuring Lord Paramount Rickard. It's essentially a pre-rebellion Starks miniseries where our goal is to keep Lyanna Stark alive. Shouldn't be that difficult. I'd like to keep her alive and not fat, because sometimes she has a tendency to get kind of fat. But keep her alive and get House Stark on the Iron Throne. This is a little... I'm thinking this is going to be kind of tricky, because normally I'm used to trying to get independence or something like that for the North, but now trying to get the North in charge of the Iron Throne, that is going to be an interesting little challenge. We'll see if we can accomplish it in 10 episodes. We may or may not. I would also like, and this is a little, just a personal addendum I'm going to add to that for the objectives that I just came up with right now. I would like to see the Iron Throne ruled from the North. So not putting a Stark down in King's Landing, but instead making Winterfell the new capital of the Iron Throne. I think that'd be interesting. That'd be an interesting thing to see. So we're playing as Lord Paramount Rickard. He's 30 years old. I think this is... God, what is it? Is this 13 or... It's either 13 or 23 years before the Rebellion. Robert's Rebellion and the end of the Targaryen Dynasty. Aerys is 25. He is actually decent. He's not crazy looking. Crazy looking. He always looks crazy, but he's not actually crazy yet. I mean, he does have some negative traits, but he's not the Mad King quite yet. And our children, Brandon is still alive, Eddard is alive, of course Lyanna is alive, and Benjen is also alive, as is our wife, Lady Paramount, Lyara. I'm not sure how she really dies, if it's like scripted in there or not, but that doesn't really matter. We need to set up the North so that we can get a strong basis for this. I can see why I already have too many vassals. Let's get rid of one of our vassals here. Who is the lowest? No, it can't be the lowest. It has to be a person who's an actual lord, not a master. Master of King's Course, Master of Dawn Forest, Lord of... Oh, wait, these are masters, though. Lord of Castle Kerwin. All right, so Castle Kerwin is right here, and he only has one vassal. We have a vassal who is in Castle Kerwin, who's a master. Where is he? Master of Dawn Forest, Lord of Castle Kerwin, Master of King's Course. Wait, this is King's Course. Oh, shit, I've just confused myself. All right, what's the High Lordship of this place? That's the High Lordship of Winterfell, so we need to keep all of that. Christ. I forget how we do this. I'm trying to figure out which vassals we can get rid of. Lord of White Harbor, the Carhold, the Rills, the Neck, Master of Torrent Square, the Blue Hills, Lord of Bear Isle, Lord of Breakstone Hill. We could probably also give Lordship of Mokaelin to somebody, even though that's a command. It's a command. I think it's supposed to be the heir title, but... It said Crown Focus now. I think it's supposed to be the heir title, but... It's a command, so periodically, when you give it to people, they eventually get booted out as a new commander gets elected or some shit. Crap. Who can we get rid of? Stony Shore, Lord of Driftwood Hall. Yes, actually, yes, I am. That is the Isle of Skagos. Lordship of King's House, High Lordship of Skagos. We cannot create that. Shit. Why can we not create this? Must directly control a province. Ah, lame. And that's a ruin. The ruin of Skane. Interesting. All right. Maybe I can look at de jure stuff. De jure kingdoms, regions. De jure regions. That's the north. De jure high lordships. Okay. Now what we can do is look through here and see if there are any direct vassals that belong to us that should actually belong to someone else. Okay, Lord Donald of Breakstone Hill. These are all direct vassals. High Lordship of the North. Clans cannot make that as well. God damn it. What can we make? Yeah, liege. Okay. Lord Rickard of the Barrowlands. He controls both of these places. And then Flint's Finger. You own all of these. Okay, so Wyman Manderly. My trusted friend. If I transfer a vassal to you, who can I give to you? Oldcastle. Oldcastle's down here. He's lord of all this stuff. Okay. Is Oldcastle here, lord of Oldcastle, Andrew? That will round out his control, won't it? That'd be nice, wouldn't it? All right, excellent. We'll do that. And then that fixes our vassal limit. Excellent. Let's go ahead and get the timer going. And now we can sit here and actually set up our council and everything. I'm really hoping that the problems I'm having with the House Redclaw series, the wars between the Great Powers. Okay, so a war has just ended. Excellent. We are also in King's Landing as Master at Arms for the Iron Throne. So we have to remember, we're actually down south. Anyways, as I was saying, I'm really hoping that we don't get the freezing issues that pretty much ended the House Redclaw series. In the 9th episode, we didn't have any problems with that with King Rhaegar. What the hell is this? Request council support. Who is this? No, I don't want to do any politics down south. I don't care about that. But what I want to do is we need to get a good master at arms who's excellent with the sword. Why? Because we have children that need to be trained in fighting. So go ahead and do join my court. And who do we have? We have Lord Brynden of the Trident. He would be fantastic to have. Let's go ahead and invite him. Is he refusing marriage still? Yes. There's also Lewin. Is he the only one? He is a formidable fighter, so let's go ahead and invite him as well. Is Sir Arthur Dane around here somewhere? Maybe. I don't see him, though. But we've got Lewin. We got Lewin. That's all I care about. We need him to be training the children. Now then, for our focus, we need to take the Iron Throne. Now, how do we do that? Independence, depose King Ares. Well, I mean, overthrow the monarchy seems to be a good way to do that. Are we honorable? We are honorable and we are just, which means if Ares finds out that we're scheming to overthrow the monarchy, he can easily force us to not do that anymore. Or, well, you know, not conspire to overthrow the monarchy. All right, Sir Brynden Tully is with us. Excellent. And Sir Lewin Martell. Let's get Sir Lewin Martell over here. Train the children. Do we have someone who's better with... Yes, collect taxes in Winterfell. Thank you. Lord Wyman is doing scheming for us. Dear Lord Paramount Rickard of the North, I hereby invite you to a grand feast. Are you carousing? You are not. He is seducing. And his friends are Lord Paramount Stefan of the Stormlands and Lord Paramount Tywin. I will travel to the feast. Hopefully he's not going to use that as a means of seducing our wife. I don't think she'd care, though. We want to see our house rule the Iron Throne. Yes, we do. That's going to be the goal. As for our focus, we might want to do war or hunting. Why? Because we have a military upbringing. We have military education, which we can improve if we choose one of these two. I'm thinking perhaps hunting, since it's going to be some time before we have enough support to where we can overthrow the monarchy and establish we're not going to establish a merchant republic, but probably a noble oligarchy where we will rule, and then if we can rule for 10 years, we can change it back to a hereditary despotic kingdom, whatever. So let's pick hunting, because I think this will give us a little bit of flavor and thrill as we're also increasing our chances of improving our martial ability, our martial education. We also have the option to get brawny, which is always a good trait to have, so let's go ahead and pick hunting. And plus, that seems like something a Stark would do. We've arrived in King's Landing, where King Ares has greeted us warmly to his feast. Excellent. He better not do anything bad. He actually might become crazy on his own. Arrange a marriage between Laura Royce and Sir Dennis Arryn. Okay, she's in... Wait a minute. Benedict Royce. Lady Jocelyn? Jocelyn. Except, are we allies with them? With the Vale? No, we're not. Because you have no children. Shit. So, as far as the North goes, getting alliances with the Trident and the Vale are going to be super, super, super important. And we have three boys and one girl. Unfortunately, we're probably going to have to marry Lyanna off. But I'm thinking it'll be for the good of the realm. You have two daughters, Catelyn and Lysa Arryn, Lord Paramount Hospitality. I'm actually going to try to sway you. And I want to set up a betrothal between Brandon Stark and Catelyn Tully. would prefer matrilineal marriage. Yeah, I know. And then Lysa is going to be betrothed to Eddard. Or would it be better for her to marry Benjen? I mean, they're roughly the same age. And then Eddard could marry maybe an Aaron. Maybe. Yeah. What is this? Oh, he's already entertaining a betrothal. Okay. I was seated beside Lord Lucas Hardy, and we've become good friends. Good. I do want to say, Lord Paramount Rickard, I am loving his glorious beard and hair. That glorious brown color. To the most excellent Lord Paramount Rickard, I have decided to accept. Good. Good. Now, okay, so we have our non-aggression pact. Lysa, I want to betroth to Benjen. Excellent. Good. Now, Lord Paramount John, do you have anyone, any errands, that would be able to marry Eddard? Becca. Becca, is she... She's a quarter. Okay. Not really what I had in mind. Are you telling me House Aaron has no children? There's Albert Aaron. Albert. And Rowena Aaron. Okay. Those are all Targaryens. Arnold, Roderick, Donald, Dennis. Okay. Probably should have married Sir Dennis to Lyara Stark. Okay, well, that's kind of unfortunate. So I don't really want any allies outside of the Riverlands and the Vale. I mean, I suppose we could try to marry into House Lannister as well. I'm thinking geography, okay? I'm thinking about geography here. Shit. Yeah, it still leaves Lyanna, and it still leaves Eddard Stark. Eddard, let's go ahead and give you a martial background. Lyanna, we will do the same, because we are northerners, and that's what we need to focus on, is martial stuff. And Brandon is nice and strong. Yeah, he's got the wolf's blood in him. I like it. Has voted for legal first knight due to returning a favor to Lord Justin. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, because that's what we need. There's also the Reach... Mina, Janna. Yeah, but I mean, I don't want allies all over the place. House Aaron has no viable people that can marry, which is really, really unfortunate. Well, no, there is Albert Aaron. What am I saying? There's Albert Aaron. Could we betroth Albert Aaron and... Oh, there's also Jocelyn. No one's going to marry 45-year-old Jocelyn. But he would be willing to marry Lyanna Stark. And she would stay in our realm until she can marry... Albert Aaron, and he is heir to the Kingdom of the Vale. Apparently he is. And that would be a great alliance for us in the future. And then that leaves, who does that leave? Who else is eligible? There isn't really anyone else that's eligible. Dennis is going to have some kids eventually, so that leaves poor Eddard. Poor Eddard sitting this one out, kind of, sort of. I don't think that, no, the squids aren't going to... My lord, I've changed my mind about the proposed marriage of Lord Brandon and Catelyn. This is because the bride stands to inherit the Kingdom of the Trident and my other titles and such. I want her to continue the line of House Tully. Reasonable. Reasonable. But, I don't like it. I don't like it. Are you still considering that betrothal between Lady Lysa? All right, the feast is over. Excellent. I've decided to accept the suggestion. Now, are you going to back out of this one as well? I don't know. Alright, so from my understanding, until the AI reneges on these betrothals, Benjen is marrying Lysa Tully, securing an alliance with the Riverlands. Lyanna is marrying Albert Aaron, who is securing an alliance with the Vale. That leaves Brandon and Eddard unmarried. Now, there are other places we could marry as well. I mean, there is Cersei Lannister, but I don't think people will like me playing the Starks and getting cozy with the Lannisters. I don't think they would like that. So what we probably could maybe do... I don't know. Are there people that can marry within House Baratheon that would be willing to marry Cassandra? She's 46. Okay, she's 46. The Reach... okay, so Lord Paramount Mace is 13, and he does have sisters... Janna and Mina. Whom, I mean, having the Reach as an ally would make all the difference. And he has two sisters, so we could double up on an alliance with the Reach. Now, geographically, they're not really located anywhere near us, but it could be good. I mean, but then also, I mean, there are no female Targaryens that I know of. Or maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there are. Brandon and Chera, no, but there is Lyanna. She's not a Targaryen, though. She's just a High Valyrian. All right, well, because I want to secure the Reach as soon as possible. So arrange a betrothal, Brandon and Janna Tully, apologies. And then we're going to have to wait for Mace to approve that. And then we can marry his other sister to one of our children. My court physician Wallace has shared some of his latest ideas with me. He wants us to fund medical endeavors. Fell into the river. Okay. Do we want to pay that? I'm already paying him and do not give him any reason. Yeah, why would I? I don't care. I don't want to give you my hard-earned cash. To the commanding, excellent. He's accepted betrothal. Now, there is a second betrothal that I would like, and that is with Eddard and your other sister, Mina. Mina and Janna Tyrells. I would have them marry my sons. Excellent. So all of our children are married off, securing the Riverlands, the Vale, and the Reach. Your friend Lord Lucas talked to you today about your fine service to King Ares II, as he should. We are a fantastic master at arms. And I believe we are swaying the Riverlands. Ooh, what is this? Lord Treasurer is gone. Commander Elric, get here and collect taxes, please. Then we have minor titles. Let's name, where is our sister-in-law. Okay, there is our wife, who is also a close member. Why are we married to... She's got to be a kinsman. I highly, highly, highly doubt that she is actually a close relative. I really hope she isn't. Let's disband our household guard. Let's get automatic plots up here and running. Auto-assign commanders, thank you. I've got 3 more bodyguards, and the bodyguards I saw looked pretty shit. So we're going to try to find better ones. There's Sir Wallace Blackshield. Invite you. We have Arnold. He's kind of old, though. Jonathor Derry. We want you. We need you. And then we've got Tygett, Lord Tygett of the Westerlands, and Sir Malcolm Birdshakes. That is an insane name. We're going to invite the Lannister, though. All right. And then let's go spend some time with Lord Hostetelli. Excellent. And then we'll just start giving these titles out to good lords of the North. Excellent. There's one more bodyguard. Hoster was happy to oblige me. Good. High Almoner will be you. The cupbearer will be someone that I absolutely trust, Rickard. The court tutor is going to be Brendan Tully. I would have you train everyone in how to be honorable, sir. Handmaiden can be our sister-in-law. Okay, that's all good. We have another bodyguard. Jonathor Derry. And then we have one more. Yes, the Lannister. Right, so Sir Tygett Lannister is currently in our realm. He does have a claim on the Kingdom of the Westerlands. Okay, let's find him someone he can marry. Let's get him married to somebody. Would he be willing to marry our aunt? It doesn't seem he would have much of a choice. Okay, do it. We'll just command him to. Why not? I think these days have really helped me getting Hoster to know and appreciate me better. Planning your visit filled me with purpose. I fulfilled all my obligations as a host. We'll do that one. Excellent. Now, we're not supposed to be plotting, but I just out of curiosity want to see if we can plot for the Iron Throne. Ah, we can plot a rally support amongst the other vassals of King Ares II of the Iron Throne in an attempt to fabricate a claim on the Seven Kingdoms of the Iron Throne. Ah, character is not Lord Paramount Rickard of the North. As Lord Paramount Rickard is honorable, his opinion of King Ares must be negative 50 or less. Doesn't have the culture group First Men. Tyranny is greater equal, is alive, has the opinion to serve title. There's a lot of conflicting conditions and requirements that we're not going to worry about right now, because I don't think we're going to be doing a whole lot of plotting. Now, conspiring in factions, perhaps, that might be okay. But Lord Rickard, unfortunately, without a claim on the Iron Throne... Well, you know what? I suppose we could have married Rhaegar to Lyanna Stark, but that's what caused Robert's Rebellion to begin with. Lord Pinmont Rickard, a great melee in the Northern tradition is to be held in Deepwood, and our dual skill is 80. Alright, it's like a tourney only for Northerners, so let's go ahead and we'll do that. We'll go do some fighting. It's no big secret Lord Bellis is after my job as Master at Arms, but he did surprise me when he asked me outright for help. Let's see, our Marshal is 20, his is 11, but he does aspire to become the Marshal. He asked nicely, and I like him. We can become close friends. We will foster more relationships. Lord Paramount Edwild of the North died in battle. I've decided to bestow upon you the title of Warden of the North. You are hereby charged with the defense of the North in the event of any foreign threat. A great honor. Excellent. After consultation with my council, I've decided to enact a law changing the rules of succession. Succession shall hereby be determined by absolute agnatic inheritance, with only male heirs allowed to inherit. Okay, I mean... Sure. Good for you, buddy. Kick the timer up here a little bit more. Independence. Lord Paramount Quellen wants... Once independence. Now, how exactly are we going to get these other lords to join our faction? All right, Hosta Tully will join us. How about you, Aaron? You will also join us. Excellent. And then you're betrothed to a Stark. Can we get an alliance with the Reach? No. Okay, he's only 13, though. We have time. The melee had finally begun, with all warriors assembling in the fighting field to begin the battle. You hold your own for a while, but you are eventually forced to yield by another competitor. Ugh. I really, really dislike it when the game automatically disqualifies you from tourneys or melees. Really annoying. Especially when we have a dual skill of 80. I mean, come on. Alright, we are now allied with the Riverlands and the Vale. While at the tournament, I joined in a conversation with other lords on how best to collect tithes. I saw a far easier way. And it caused quite an argument with many lords disagreeing with my stance, but the more I talked, the more I convinced myself that I was right. And we lose some stewardship, so maybe we shouldn't be going to tourneys anymore. Because I don't like permanently losing stats just because. Very annoying, especially since we have 80 combat skill. We shouldn't have been removed so easily. I mean, what are you going to do? After many hours, okay, that's fine. Can we make you the crown focus? Ooh, we can. We made Winterfell the crown focus. Is there anything else we can build? We can build a personal study. Do it. We really should be building up a war chest. It's no big secret. Lord Howard is after my job. Let's be friends with him as well. Super. We'll just make friends with everybody. Okay, our friends are in our faction. Depose King Ares II. Could you join our faction, please? Elbert Arryn. Lady Liara is going to become... Lady Paramount of the Vale? I'm not really sure. Now then, we need to have good guardians. Brynden Tully is a pretty damn good guardian, though. Eddard Tully, Liara. So Brynden Tully is actually training all of our children. And he's got great traits, except for stubborn. It's not that bad of a trait, actually. You only lose intrigue and learning, and that's really not going to hurt House Stark all that much. Your friend Lord Bellis talked to you today about your fine service to King Ares. It's good to be appreciated. Yeah, no, we're not going to fight in any more melees. His inherited lordship of Silverreed, okay? Use your study. Ooh, nice. Are you going to let me click on my goddamn study? There we go. Jesus. Write a book. This book shall be the accomplishments of my house. We could write it about our wife. I'm not really sure if that's worthwhile. I mean, she's only 31. Surely she could have more kids, right? But then again, we're not very good with writing, and we might actually make her pissed at us. So the same thing also goes for writing our history. Our diplomacy. We're a soldier, okay? We're a soldier and a hunter. We're really not that good with writing. So let's go just stick with the faith. I've discovered a promising candidate. Do I want to strong-arm Lord Tywin into our faction? I can see Tywin has sympathy for the Valyrian faith, and I know exactly why that is. It's because if you go into the bloodlines, House Lannister for some reason shares blood with the Targaryens, which as far as I can tell, is not the way it is. It's really, that's not how it's supposed to work. But regardless, I mean, fine. Let's threaten him. He's probably going to disagree, but whatever. Okay, so he disagreed. So he's probably going to support, Ares. The king, that is. Probably going to support Targaryen rule. That is, unless, of course, Quellian? The squids are no longer plotting independence. What is this? What is this? Please support me by voting in the council, and he will, we will have a favor from him. I will accept. And because I've turned off show me favors, we're going to call him into our plot right now. We actually can't. Asked to join factions. Can join. He can't join us. Plot to incite revolt. Improve relations with the king. They absolutely despise each other. Seducing my spouse. Oh, Ares. Okay, so Ares. Oh, Rayla died of depression. Ares is now widowed. And he's cruel and depressed. So he's... Okay, so he's going down the path of darkness pretty quickly. So what can we do? Can we make him like us a little bit more? Nah, probably not. Because the person we would be asking to improve relations with the king despises the king. So I don't think he'll have any real motivation to improve relationships. We'll hold on to that favor then. Although I'm gonna utterly forget that he owes us a favor. Whatever. Browsing through my library, I noticed a dusty old tome. On closer inspection, it appears to be a collection of stories and legends from old Valyria. Perhaps I should read it. Yes, how interesting. I am surprised. Reading Valyrian legends. Interesting. During his visit to my court, the Master of Laws of the Iron Throne, Lord Paramount Huster of the Trident, has really convinced me of what a benevolent and peaceful ruler his liege, King Ares, is. I feel a new appreciation for the king. Your friend, Lord Howard, talked to you today about your fine service. Excellent. So the king is going down a dark path. Who owns Dragonstone? It's Rhaegar. Now see, this is where we could have married Lyanna to him. Because now he technically has his own land, so he's not really being told what to do by the king anymore. It's so hard to think about what I could do to endear Lord Paramount Hoster to me. I'm already so perfect, after all. I will write him a letter about me. I'll send him one of my statues. Fine. 6 gold. How peculiar. He was not impressed. Okay, well, he's a bastard then. My ally Lord Paramount John Arryn has tried to have Lord Nestor of the Paps arrested. I really don't care. Really don't care about that. Liege loyalists. Mwah. Overthrow the monarchy of the Iron Throne is now at 70%. We need to get Lord Paramount John of the Vale into our cause. Because with King Ares descending into madness so quickly, we could very well end this miniseries prematurely, which if we do get to the Iron Throne and everything, we're going to just rule as the Starks. From Winterfell, but over the Seven Kingdoms. You know what I'm trying to say. But we will rule as the Starks for quite some time until we hit, the 10th episode for the miniseries. But if we can get Jon on our side, along with the Trident, man, even if we can get the Reach in there too, then the Starks are going to take over. But King Ares is, I think he's really trying to, he really is trying to upset the delicate balance. This book recounts the most fascinating legends of dragons. There were discovered some 5,000 years ago by the Valyrians in the 14 Fires. The Valyrians mastered the art of raising dragons, using them as weapons of war to carve out their empire. Intriguing. Millennia later, the Targaryens used the last dragons to conquer the Seven Kingdoms, but now they're gone. I want a dragon. The dragons are dead. I've never seen this event before, so I'm not really sure what it entails, but if there's a chance that we could awaken the dragons of old and have them fight for House Stark. Now, the likelihood that we're going to be able to tame a dragon, very, very, very low. Very, very low. Sometimes dragons are very... Well, I mean, if the dragon is small enough, maybe, and if you can befriend it, maybe a non-Valyrian can tame it. I want a dragon. I do. I want a dragon. I want to see where this event goes. You never realize how controversial old faiths can be. The old god's faith can be. I must finish this book to clear my mind. The peasants have risen up in White Harbor. That's really not that many. It's only 1,100. You have finished writing your thoughts on the old god's faith. Do we want the mystic trait? Intrigue +2, plot power defense +15. dragon hatching chance plus 25. Well, I mean, considering. All things considered. But if we get this trait, though, is this going to make it impossible for us to become a hunter? I don't even know if the hunter lifestyle trait is even worthwhile getting. But if we do find a dragon egg, this would give us a much better chance, and it would give us plot power defense. That feels too good to pass up. That feels too good to pass up, and I don't really care if maesters don't like us. Alright, screw it. We'll do Mystic. I need that intrigue and plot power defense and the dragon hatching chance. Oh, damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Rickard, you're too honorable for your own good, sir. You're too honorable. Permit me to remind you of your obligations and duty as my sworn vassal. To form a conspiratorial faction would be in direct violation of these, and I must ask for your promise never to do so. So he doesn't really know that we're actually doing anything, but he suspects it, so he wants to remind us of our noble obligations. And as you can see, because we're just and honorable, there's no way. There's no way we can get out of this. True scheming is not the honorable way of doing things. Perhaps you are right, my liege. If he is, please decide it would be in your best interest to comply with this demand. Lord Rickard, Lord Paramount Rickard, might not be able to conspire to take over the Iron Throne. We may have to wait for a badass like Lord Brandon to come along, who is strong, a great fighter, and has green dreams. That is so cool. I wonder if he can become a warg. I think that's how... I don't have a lot of experience with becoming wargs or anything like that, but... I'm pretty sure Green Dreams is on the way to getting some kind of animal familiar that follows you around everywhere, like a direwolf or something. Lord Brandon could become the next Robb Stark riding a giant direwolf. I know Robb Stark didn't actually ride a giant direwolf, but I like to pretend that he did. He should have, goddammit. But, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to wrap this first episode up for this new series up right here. If you enjoyed this episode, please... comment, subscribe, share. Forgot my outro. I have been the Golden Joeblivion. This has been the all too honorable Lord Paramount Rickard of the North. And until next time, I will see you all later.